sneakers you were talking about?
Yeah, brand new.
Okay. Those are them?
Brand new.
Okay, yes. Okay, they're here, so that we've taken care of those two parts. Is it correct that she gave you $250?
No.
How much do you say she gave?
She gave me $150 to babysit the kids.
$150 and it's to babysit the kids?
Mm-hmm.
So she wasn't paying rent?
No.
All right, now, how long did you watch her kids?
It was overnight for 2 days. And I took them also, picked them in the morning.
So why did she pay you $150 for that? Were you supposed to be watching the kids for a bunch of time or just for what?
Just
she paid you in advance. How does she know?
For 4 days.
Okay, so that was the money for the 4 days. What happened on day 6?
Because she didn't go to work.
Okay.
I asked her for 2 days, but she didn't go to work for 2 more days. And then the next day, which was Saturday, I asked when she left.
Okay, and according to her, you locked her out?
No, they locked her out. We was on the phone texting and whatever. But she said, oh, I have to pack my stuff now. I said, okay, well, she said, so
what are you guys arguing about?
I don't even, it was something small. She just kept, like, cursing me out, like, coming real crazy at me, like, cursing at me and being real rude to me. And I'm like, why are you, you know, being like that? I'm just, I think I asked her what was the kids doing or what was she doing, just, you know, basically checking up on them. And she didn't like that. What you texting me for? Why? What? For what?
Did she have your kid at that point?
Yeah. So I'm like, I'm just checking on y'all. You know, that's it. Well, are you sure? Because I can leave right now. All my stuff is packed. I'm waiting for you. So I came. All my stuff was packed. I said, you don't have to leave. She was on the phone calling the cops, whatever. Oh, she's
what's she calling the cops about?
I have no idea.
Well, she says that because you were...
She hung up with the cops like, oh, no, we talked it out. And hung up. It was over. She left. Came back and then started coming up with this $100 thing. I said, you know what, you gotta go. And that was that.
And then you tell her, you gotta go. Did you change your lock?
No, I didn't change the lock.
Okay. So you tell her, you gotta go. And then how do you end up in Landlord Tenant Court?
She took me to Landlord Tenant Court.
Okay, so you take her to Landlord Tenant Court and tell the judge what?
Basically, she lying about everything she said.
What do you say to the court in Landlord Tenant Court?
Because, Judge, when we got off
what
the bus...
What do you say to the judge in Landlord Tenant Court?
What I said to the judge is in Tenant Court that she took all these things from me and she kicked me out. Once we got off the bus, me and my 2 sons and her son, she didn't inform me. She just stepped off and went about her business around the corner with her son. When I went to go tap the door to see was it open to just go upstairs in the house, all my stuff was just sitting there. She didn't inform me no where was her stuff kicked out or she put my stuff...
You want to be treated. She did business with companies that shared her values, like Mutual of Omaha Insurance Company, a Mutual of Omaha company. When my mother passed away, her United of Omaha policy had to cover her fuel expenses and bills, and had money on its way to us within 24 hours.
United of Omaha is here to take care of you. When you call the number on your screen, we'll help find the right policy for you. If you're between 45 and 85, you can get coverage up to $25,000 with no medical exam. Call us right now at the number on your screen.
Now I know how to take care of my family, even after I'm gone.
United of Omaha guaranteed whole life insurance. Call or go online now. Be there for their future.
Atlanta Frost Premium Sliced Meats have no byproducts.
Join the call.
Hey, Baloney here.
I thought this was a no byproducts call.
Atlanta Frost Premium, a slice above.
George woke up in pain, but he has plans today.
So he took a leave. If he'd taken Tylenol, he'd be stopping for more pills right now. Only a leave has the strength to stop tough pain for up to 12 hours with just one pill. Believe, all day strong.
I struggled with depression. I thought I needed cigarettes to cope. I was able to quit smoking, and then I started running. Now I feel a lot better.
You can't quit. For free help, call 1-800-QUIT-NOW.
Cleaning floors with a mopping bucket is a hassle. Swiffer WetJet makes cleaning easy. It's safe to use on all finished surfaces, trapping dirt and liquid inside. outside the pad. Plus, it prevents streaks better than a microfiber strip mop. For a convenient clean, try Swiffer Wet Jet.
Want to know what happens when I step off the bench? Follow the People's Court on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and our very own YouTube channel for exclusive courtroom moments, behind-the-scenes footage, and more.
Why is it that two people can be super good friends and they move in together and they end up hating each other?
Yeah, once you get to know a person, like, you don't really know how they are, like, when they move in together. Like, you can be a friend with someone, but moving in is, like, a completely different thing.
Gotcha. What do you say?
I think that when you're spending that much time with somebody, things may come to light that you wouldn't normally see otherwise, just day to day.
Do you know the saying that this reminds everybody of the saying?
No.
Really? Does anybody know the saying? Familiarity breeds contempt. Going inside the courtroom.
Where was your stuff? Downstairs in the lobby. The cops came. They even came with me to her office. We went even to her office. And basically, they saying that she's wrong. She didn't do that. And I even got report from her office.
She wasn't working.
She took the $100 bill, which I had on the
jewelry. Did the police come that day?
Yes, they came. Because she is falsely lying at this moment. She just put my stuff downstairs in the lobby without no knowledge. I didn't know. I'm thinking when we getting off the bus, I'm coming to bring her son because, again, she had somewhere to go, which was to the clinic. So she was taking her son with her.
So you just said that got off the bus.
Upstairs, you know, and continue on with our day. But when a neighbor, because the cops asked a neighbor in the window, the first floor to your left, can you please come downstairs and open the door for us? When they came downstairs and opened the door, all my stuff was just everywhere. The cops said, wait,
I'm not understanding. Do you have a key to the place?
She took it.
Wait. You're out and about with your son.
Yes.
And then you come back to the apartment. Mm-hmm. Why are you calling a neighbor to let you in?
Because she took the key.
But when did she take the key?
She then took the key. She I paid her the $25 for this so-called key, Judge. She so-called took her own key and said, oh, well, the office said, another day or something, I have to come back.
So you never had a key?
No, she took hers off of her own chain and gave me hers. And she did not tell me that.
What about the groceries?
Well, at the time, she said she had a few stamps with $1,000 or whatever the case may be. Not my business. Not. That's hers. You can go to ShopRite, get what you and your son eat, and I took her boys also with me. So they can pick out what they want. They picked out whatever they wanted. We all picked out. We got to the checkout. I checked out. We got home. She asked me how much I spent. I told her, I don't know the receipt at, but I thought I dropped it. So I guess she found it in the bag next to whatever. I haven't seen it. But I did go to the grocery store because she instructed
me. Did she tell you how much to spend?
She never said it.
Oh, did she tell you something about how much you spent?
No, she asked for a receipt and I didn't have it.
And then when she found it, momentarily.
She never said it. She never said anything about it.
She never complained.
Never. Never said anything about it. And when she left, she could have took the food with her. At any time, she never said anything about the food. She just kept saying something about the sneakers and the walkie-talkies.
Did she pay you $25 for a key?
Yes. I gave her my key off my ring because the maintenance man couldn't go get the key at the time.
But why would you not then have charged her rent if you're charging her for a key?
Because she wasn't staying here.
Yeah, but she was, because she worked 2 days and then she was there the other.
But because she can't. I live in subsidized. I can't have people live with me. You see what I'm saying?
We gotta say she wasn't staying there. We can't live in subsidized housing and then sublet and charge
her. Yeah, so she couldn't.
Well, we can, but apparently we did.
She was living at the live-in, her job, whatever the case may be. The only thing she wanted me to do was watch her kids.
You know what? I have no idea which of the two of you is telling me the truth.
Yeah.
I honestly have no idea. All right. Look, ladies, I have no idea who's in the right. But, I have, you know, when I'm in court, I can't just feel bad for somebody. I have to see proof of the stuff that you're saying. Mm-hmm. And you don't have a receipt for the $250.
You agreed on days 1 and 2, she watched your child overnight. She said you gave her $150 and that's for watching your child overnight. You say she stole money from your wallet, but I don't feel that you've proved that. I do see an issue with the groceries if you're telling her you gotta go, because you're getting smart with me. And do you have the key?
She has the key. She took the key when she took the boys out of the bus.
What I'm going to do is, based on everything I've heard, you have the sneakers, you have the walkie-talkies, and you have... Is there anything else in that bag
everything
that you
want? Everything, whatever was left in the car.
I
don't want these not brand new. So what I want these for, the sneakers is brand new. My son ain't never wear them.
So now, what you mean?
Me? I'm like, yes, I did. Again, if she was going to pack my things when the cops came and we went to her building...
Look at her friend.
...all my bags, why this and the walkie-talkies wasn't in it? It was cute. And my groceries. She's not making no sense.
Everybody stop talking. I don't want to hear anything.
She's not making no sense.
Up to now, who said those are your kid's sneakers? Now you look at the bottom of it, and now you're telling me he's never worn them, so they can't...
They've been worn. These are brand new.
We're done. We're done.
We can be
on
done.
The groceries, I am ordering you
that's
to
what
pay
you said
half of the groceries, $85 for the plan.
Okay, we are going to take a break when we come back.
$85. That's a good one.
Is a federal prosecutor. I saw some of the worst crimes. I prosecute some of the biggest corporations. That skill is what I brought to the civil practice. If you've been injured in an accident, call us today. 1-800-233-7000.
Your new career is just down the road. Benefits of being a truck driver for me get phone number.
Ante was diagnosed with a rare form of cancer that put him in the hospital for almost a year. During that time, his aunt, Tessera, started a fundraiser for his cause. But Ante and his mother, Tasha, never saw a dime. And they brought Tessera here to get some answers because they believe she took the money and ran. All this and more on today's Steve Wilkos Show.
Tasha, you believe that your sister stole money from your son, right?
Yes, I do.
Tell me what happened.
2 years ago, my son was diagnosed with a very rare bone cancer, Ewing sarcoma. He had a massive watermelon-sized tumor in his chest. And so I'm also a mother of 5 other children. So when this happened, I had to quit my job. We lived about an hour away from the hospital, so I had to commute back and forth with my son. It was financially very difficult. $600 a month in gas. Once he started treatment, chemotherapy, it was an intensive chemotherapy and radiation combined, which they normally don't do, but because of this particular type of cancer, they had to attack it aggressively. And so I was at the hospital every single day with Avante, and balancing back and forth. So financially, I was strapped. My car needed tires, my car needed brakes, you know, all the commuting and everything. A family member said, I'm gonna give your sister this money, and I'm going to start a fund. My sister said, I'm gonna start a fund for you. The next couple days later, me and my mom were at the hospital. She came in, she said, somebody at my job donated another $75. So what I'm gonna do is take this money and go buy actual donation boxes and put them up so we can collect a lot of money. And
to help you, so yeah, you can take care of your
family. So we can do the financial aspects of it. My mom was there when she came and told us both at the same time that she had collected the money, she was gonna buy the boxes. We asked her several times. She said, I'm gonna bring the boxes, I'm gonna bring the boxes. We never got the boxes. This was an extremely difficult time. My son, I didn't know whether he was gonna live or die, you know? And she never came back after the money got taken for the whole year. She never came back to help at the hospital. I don't know why. Like I said, I had two kids in the hospital. One, my son was getting chemotherapy, and then my other son got admitted into ICU. And I called her, I said, I need help. I got the other kids at home. Can you come? Can you help? She said, I'll be there at 8:30. You know, this is after the boxes because I needed her so bad. I just thought I would call her.
You got the money now.
I just need you to come help me. And she said, okay, I'll be there at 8:30. And then that night at 8:30, I got a text message saying, I'm not coming because you didn't watch my dog.
Because you didn't watch your dog.
So Avante, who was getting chemotherapy, was in ICU with his brother the whole time, taking care of him while I'm at the house, you know, with the other kids, running back and forth. It was just really difficult.
Were you close with your sister before all this?
Very close. She was always very good to the kids, you know, very good to me.
And how's the relationship now?
Bad. Really bad. Just because she thinks, I don't know why she doesn't believe she took the money. She thinks that my mom has convinced us that she took the money, but in reality, she told me she had the money. You know what I mean? Like she said,
Yes,
and I'm going to buy the donation boxes. I'm going to put them out. And my mom was calling me saying, did you get the money? And she knew how much I needed it. And so every time my mom called me, I would call to Sarah. Did you get the money? And to Sarah would go and return and attack my mom. I don't know why.
And you said your son was getting chemotherapy and radiation?
Chemotherapy and radiation, which was massive to his throat, to his neck. Couldn't eat or drink for 40 minutes.
Okay, that's for
She said, well, I'm not going to give you any cash. I will buy you gas cards. And I'm like, how are you going to dictate what I'm going to spend? I mean, I'm responsible.
The money that's still
here
for you.
Exactly. How are you going to dictate? I'm in control of it. So I'm going to get gas cards and I'm going to buy Avante his food.
And did she give you any gas cards or food?
No, but listen to this. When Avante was diagnosed, the first month he was in the hospital getting chemotherapy, he threw up the hospital food, which made him not be able to eat it for the whole year. So not only did I had to buy all of his food, which when you're going through chemotherapy, you have to get everything. I went and got three or four things. I spent twice as much money a month on food.
Now, this would be an all-time low of somebody doing something, you know.
That's the thing. I know she took the money because she told me that she got the money. The family member said she got the money.
Did she ever say what she did?
She did bring a sandwich, a Subway sandwich one time. I called her from, I live an hour away from the hospital. She lives close. I said, can you bring Avante dinner? She said, I'm using the money to buy the boxes. I don't have the money. I'm going to buy the boxes.
Are these the most expensive boxes in the world?
Well, you know, I don't know. I never seen the boxes.
Tiffany boxes?
But a family member told me that they actually went with her to different places, locations, and she was going checking on boxes. So I don't know if she bought the boxes. I don't know what she did. I don't know how much money she collected. I don't, you know, at that point. But I'll tell you this, after that, I started my own and had people, you know, you just deposit into an account. And within a week, lots of money was collected, you know, because you know, I don't know.
Good for you for taking it in your own hands.
My mom did a lot of it. She did. Once the money got, like I said, I was driving 50 miles each way with all tires, you know, not because I couldn't afford them.
Right.
To go from working and being, you know, a financial stable.
That kind of situation will blow a lot of families up. What do you hope happens today?
I just hope that she admits that she took the money.
And if she does that, say if she admits it, and I guess we gave her a lie detector test.
Yeah, you did.
But say if she admits that she took the money, could you patch things up with her?
I want to. I have already forgiven
her. You probably need her, right?
We went through a horrible thing. When you go through your child suffering with cancer, everything else is irrelevant.
Right, right.
I love my sister.
That's a healthy attitude.
I love her. I just want her. She needs to be real with herself and acknowledge mom didn't start this.
These are the kind of things that you really puts a better reflection on life and what it's all about and what it means. We went through in my family the same thing with one of my nephews went through cancer, and it's scary when it happens to kids because they think, oh my God, if something happens, and the financial stress of it all. I've seen it firsthand, so I know exactly what you went through. Let's bring out your sister to Sarah. Was I saying that correctly?
Yeah.
Let's bring her out to Sarah.
Tasha, how dare you? I was there for you. I was there for you. You tell us, Mom. Tasha, I was there for you. I came to Avante when you needed it. I was there for you. You took me out of the room, Tasha. You told me to leave the room, and I told you, Dad, we were raised better than that.
When did I wait? Stop. When did I tell you to leave the room?
The night, Tasha, you said you didn't. You were agitated. Me and Mom were there. You said you didn't.
Because your mom
didn't
want anybody there.
You know why?
I want to tell one that we were raised.
I didn't get the boxes.
I was watching the kids.
Did somebody at your work give you some money? No, I never got any donations. Ever. And that was the whole starter thing.
And
like,
what did you do with
do whatever. Money? I bought him sandwiches or food, whatever he wants.
You said you bought him one sandwich.
No, I asked. I would bring
him
food.
He
would call me and say, hey, I want this or I want that. And actually, what she's talking about is my mom was there. When I said, okay, so you have $5 left, Avante, and that's when this all started.
Okay, let me ask you, she said one night she just wanted you to come because she had two children in the hospital, and you said you wouldn't watch my daughter?
Yeah, because I had a family, big family thing going on, and I called her and asked her to take care of
having chemo.
I called her and asked her to hold my dog in a kennel, and I had somebody.
It was who to Sarah?
No, I had two. I had somebody else's child.
You weren't anywhere. This is a month, 2 months after you left out of California.
No.
Did you pocket any money?
Never.
That was supposed to go to her son.
Never.
Did you ever put on any fundraiser boxes?
No, never.
And why didn't you put out the boxes?
Because I was being hassled and they were calling me all the time.
Why would we be fine if you didn't say
I was told not even get involved in not to get involved in it.
And that's. But you started
why
it.
Why did you disappear? If you didn't do anything wrong, why did you disappear?
She kicked me out of the hospital.
I kicked everybody because I wanted people
besides
to go take
mom,
care of my kids.
Isn't it fair that somebody whose son is going through cancer, that, you know, if our kids have a life-threatening disease, couldn't we be excused for being out of our minds a little bit?
Yeah, we can.
Even if you didn't do it, let's say, let's forget about the fundraising. Let's forget about the boxes.
Yeah.
Do you see how you're acting right now?
Wait.
Her son could have lost his life.
Yes, I know. That's what
you're
so good at.
You got kicked out of a room.
No, because I thought my family was dying.
Yeah, you're deep.
I thought my family was dying and had to get back.
And the Tony Award goes to Sarah.
Anything you want to shout out about your aunt?
I love you, Auntie. But I do believe you did take the money.
If your nephew can face the prospect of beating cancer, I think you can face the prospect of telling... How you doing, Mom?
I'm okay.
Really, the good thing about this story, the worst part of it's all, your grandson had cancer. Hey, it's a miracle you beat it. He's healthy now.
Yes.
I mean, he's in remission for 9 months now, which is a great thing. And so that's the good thing about the story. The worst part of it is over. But now there's some questions of, hey, during this struggle, when I really needed some financial help, your daughter's saying to your sister, hey, you said you were going to collect money, you were going to help me out, you were going to get boxes, and you never did that and then it disappeared. What would you like to say, Mom?
I'm here supposedly because I started the rumor that she took the money, and I did not do that. We were all in the room when she said she got $75, I believe. And she was going to go buy more boxes.
Never get $75.
They asked her.
Is there some reason you're mad at your mom?
My mom has never liked me. My mom has never been.
You're
my
a cold
mom has never liked me. I know you laugh, and
just because you like turned into the biggest victim on my stage.
I'm not a victim. Yeah. I'm not. That's the reason I called, though.
I know,
that's the reason I called. Because we've never been close. I feel like she just made it up.
Behind it, the pit got started because the person who gave me the money called me and said I gave her the money. You should get it.
Gave her $20.
Well, they said it was a different amount. He said it was a different amount.
Well, I could have kept.
And then you came into the hospital saying people had my job.
Okay. Like I said, I'm not trying to downplay anybody's feelings.
Be mine. Because I'm the victim. And I'm not trying to be the victim.
Even after this, you attacked Mom. My mom didn't even say nothing to you, DeSarah. She never once even accused you personally.
Mom called me and told me I was a thief.
I just can't believe that a woman whose son went through this horrible chemotherapy and radiation is now saying she's making up this whole story about boxes and new fundraising after her son
beat cancer. That was supposed to happen. That was supposed to happen.
But it didn't.
No.
I know.
And no boxes even went out.
I know.
So why didn't you help me at all?
I needed to
Care around
there.
I needed more than
the cancer survivor, sir. Let's bring him up.
Go on, baby boy. Come on, baby. Yeah.
Well, I honestly, I didn't think I was gonna die. Like me, like all my family members, they said I was probably gonna pass, and I had the option, you know, not to do chemo and just to live the rest of my life, you know.
Take free, a chance.
You know, but I believe, you know, I have faith in the chemo. I'm a really sciencey guy, so.
All right.
That's the greatest part of the story is that you underwent this. It's a pretty horrible treatment. What it does to the inside and how it makes you feel. Just terrible. But you went through it, you overcame it, you're in remission now, and that's the great thing. Anything you want to shout out about your aunt?
I love you, Auntie.